Okay, so blood types are needlessly confusing. Here's a chart of who can donate blood to people of other types. What? Okay, I'm confused. So I found this one, and then this one.
Huh?
All right, meet Alice, Bob, and Dave. They're these antigen things you can have on your blood cells. But let's keep thinking of them as little monsters. You can't take blood with a monster in it who you aren't already used to. Your antibodies will go defend yourself from these unknown, but you know, otherwise friendly monsters. So that's why blood types need to be a thing, but we think of them as two things. You've really got two major blood types, one for Alice and Bob and another for Dave. And they're written completely differently. For Alice and Bob, you just take attendance. If Alice is there, write down A. If Bob is, put down B. Both are, put both. And for some reason, if you've got none, put an O, because it kind of looks like a zero, I guess, which means none. Okay, anyway, for Dave, it's just a quick, do you have Dave? Yes or no, one or zero. Or, because this is a medical thing, positive or negative. Since your body cares if the blood has any of the three, whenever anyone talks about their blood type, they squish both the letter and the sign together. This is how we end up with this mess. And this would be easy to fix. Put Dave on the attendance. Get rid of that plus and minus and bring in the D. And why not call the O type what it is? A not type. Zero. Now it's way simpler to get how different blood types relate. It's plainly easier to see which blood types can give to other types. I mean, you could replace this whole chart with one sentence. You can't get blood from someone who has a letter you don't have. Let me know what you think. Or, you know, why not just stick with this confusing, jumbled mix of blood typing systems?